लेट्स टेक अप मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चन बेस्ड ऑन केमिकल बॉन्डिंग. द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज आउट ऑफ द फॉलोइंग द मोस्ट कोवेलेंट कंपाउंड इज ए पार्ट लिथियम क्लोराइड, बी पार्ट लिथियम ब्रोमाइड, सी पार्ट लिथियम फ्लोराइड एंड डी पार्ट लिथियम आयोडाइड. करेक्ट आंसर इज डी पार्ट लिथियम आयोडाइड. नाउ व्हाई लिथियम आयोडाइड इज द करेक्ट आंसर, बिकॉज आयोडीन इज लीस्ट इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव एंड लार्जेस्ट इन साइज. It has maximum tendency to form covalent bond. So lithium iodide is the correct answer. Lithium fluoride will be most ionic out of these, because fluorine is most electronegative atom, and most electronegative atom can form ionic bond. Next question. Chloride of a metal is MCl2. MCl2 means valency of metal is 2. The formula of phosphate we want to find out. Phosphate is 3 minus. So the formula of metal phosphate will be M3PO4 whole twice. So the correct answer is B part, M3PO4 whole twice. This is the way of finding out the formula. From MCl2 find out the valency of M, which will be 2. And phosphate PO4 3 minus. So formula will become, this 3 will come this side, this 2 will come this side, so you will get M3PO4 whole twice. Let's take up next question. Which of the following has highest boiling point? First option HI, second HF, third HBr, fourth HCl. Correct answer is HF. Why HF? Because HF molecules are associated with intermolecular hydrogen bonding. That is why it is liquid, and liquid will have highest boiling point, whereas HCl, HBr, HI do not form hydrogen bond and they are gases and have low boiling point. Lowest boiling point is of HCl. Why HCl? Because in case of gases, the boiling point depends upon surface area. HCl has lowest surface area, then HBr, then HI. So HCl has lowest boiling point among all these. HCl has lower than HBr, which has lower than HI, and highest is HF because it is liquid due to intermolecular hydrogen bonding. Next question, which of the following molecule has linear structure? A part CO2, B part NO2, C part SO2 and D part SiO2. Correct answer is A part. Carbon dioxide is a linear molecule with bond angle 180, because both sides there is double bond. It is sp hybridization, so it is linear. NO2 is a bent molecule with one double bond and one coordinate bond, and there is one odd electron, we call it one electron, which is called odd electron. SO2 is also a bent molecule with a lone pair of electron. SiO2 is three-dimensional covalent solid, so its structure cannot be represented in the simple manner, because it has three-dimensional structure. It is three-dimensional covalent solid. Next question we are going to take up. CO2 is isostructural with A part HgCl2, B part SnCl2, C part SO2 and D part NO2-. Correct answer is HgCl2. Carbon dioxide has linear shape with bond angle 180. Similarly, HgCl2 also has linear shape with bond angle 180, whereas SnCl2 is a bent molecule because it has one lone pair of electron. SO2 is also a bent molecule due to the presence of lone pair of electron. NO2- also is bent molecule with a lone pair of electron. So correct answer is A part HgCl2, which is linear like CO2. Isostructural means same structure, that is both are linear molecule. Next question is very important and thoughtful question. It requires higher order of thinking skills. The atomic numbers of three elements, L has Z, M has Z plus 1 and P has Z plus 2. Respectively, if P belongs to alkali metals, it means M will belong to noble gases. Why noble gases? Noble gases is group 18 elements. After group 18 elements, we have group 1 elements to which alkali metals belong to. And Z will belong to halogens. Why halogens? Because halogens belong to group 17 and noble gases belong to group 18. And alkali metals are after group 18, that is group 1. We have to find out what kind of bond will be formed between L and P. P is alkali metal, so it can lose one electron forming P positive ion. L is halogen, it has got 7 valence electrons, so it can gain one electron to form negative ion. So the bond between P and L will be electrovalent bond. So the correct answer is A part, that is they will form electrovalent bond, which I have explained. Next question, the central atom of the molecule has 33% S character. Its geometry will be A part planar, B part pyramidal, C part V-shape, D part T-shape. 33% S character means it is sp2 hybridization. Because in sp2 hybridization, 33% S character and 67% P character will be there. And the shape of sp2 hybridized orbitals is planar with bond angle 120. This is sp2 hybridized orbitals and this bond angle is 120. So the shape is planar. So the correct answer is A part. Next question, we have to find out the hydrogen bonding is strongest in which of the following? OH with sulfur, SH with oxygen, FH with fluorine and FH with oxygen. Correct answer is C part. Why it is C part correct answer? Because fluorine is most electronegative atom and smallest in size among oxygen, sulfur and fluorine. So being smallest in size and highly electronegative, it will form strongest hydrogen bond. The strength of bond depends upon the electronegativity and size of the atom. Next, we are going to take up the shape of ethylene molecule. Options are regular tetrahedral, pyramidal, planar or linear. Now, ethylene molecule can be represented like this. And here each carbon is sp2 hybridized and bond angle is 120. So the shape of ethylene molecule is planar because of sp2 hybridization. Correct answer is C part. Which of the following halogens has highest bond energy? Now bond energy depends upon size of the atom. Options are F2, Cl2, Br2 and I2. Now from this observation, it looks like that highest bond dissociation energy or bond energy is in case of F2 molecule. But the actual answer is Cl2. Why Cl2 is the correct answer and not F2? The reason is fluorine has exceptionally small size and there is a repulsion between valence electron of fluorine atom, due to which this bond breaks easily and has low bond dissociation energy as compared to chlorine, in which repulsion between the lone pair of electron is comparatively less because it is bigger in atomic size. So the correct answer is Cl2 has highest bond dissociation energy and not F2. B part is the correct answer. In the formation of chemical bond, A option is the potential energy decreases. Second option, the potential energy increases. C part, potential energy remains unaffected. D part, potential energy first decreases and then increases. Correct answer is D part. Why D part is correct answer? Now, if you remember the potential energy diagram, this represents zero line. When hydrogen atoms are far away from each other, there is neither any force of attraction and nor force of repulsion. Therefore, the energy is taken as zero. When two hydrogen atoms approach each other, energy goes on decreasing. It becomes minimum at a particular internuclear distance and after that it increases. This internuclear distance at which it becomes minimum in case of hydrogen is called bond length, and this is 74 picometer. And this lowering of energy which takes place, which is called bond energy, will be 436 kilojoules per mole in case of hydrogen. So the correct answer is D part. Next question, the maximum number of hydrogen bonds formed by a water molecule in the ice are 4. Why it can form 4 hydrogen bonds? One of the bond will be formed by this hydrogen atom. One of the bond will be formed by this hydrogen atom. There is a delta positive charge on this hydrogen and delta positive charge on this hydrogen. Now one of the hydrogen bond will be formed by this oxygen. Another hydrogen bond will be formed by the same oxygen downward because it has 2 delta negative charge. So the bond will be 4 bonds will be formed by each water molecule, and each water molecule is tetrahedrally bonded to 4 other molecules, leading to hexagonal structure of ice. Next question, the weakest bond of the following: A part ionic bond, B part covalent bond, C part hydrogen bond, D part metallic bond. Correct answer is hydrogen bond. Why hydrogen bond is the weakest bond? Because this is the bond between electronegative atom and hydrogen. So this is not require involving any sharing of electrons. This is the force of attraction between electronegative atom, fluorine, like fluorine, oxygen and nitrogen, and hydrogen of another molecule, and this is comparatively weaker bond. Ionic bond, covalent bond are quite strong. Metallic bond, in some cases it is strong, in some cases it is weak. So the correct answer is hydrogen bond among these. So C part is the correct answer.